Hello guys, MJ Cubing Max here. Today, I'm gonna be showing you how to adjust your cube. So what you might need for this, you'll obviously need lube, whichever one you choose, just whatever lube you want, a screwdriver to adjust your cube, and probably maybe some ear what, and just to clean out the hard to get areas. You'll also probably, it can be a messy job, so you might want some gloves. And also, you will probably need some baby wipes to clean whatever you need. And maybe you might want some tin cans to hold some extra lube, but that's optional. And so is the gloves. That's optional, and yeah, so let's get started. So what you're gonna want to do first is get the cube that you want. If it's GAN or something that has its own adjustment system, I cannot show you how to adjust that, but I can show you how to lube it. But for the adjustment part, this is what you're gonna need if it's like some budget cube, like where you, so, I normally just take the white center and pop it off right there, and there's a screw. So get the screw, and you know, righty tighty, lefty loosey, and so like it, and just tighten it the way you want. And then when you're done, just put the cap back on and see if it turns right. And if it feels looser than this one, let's say you want it loose. So this one's loose, but this one's too tight. You can do that same thing with the yellow. But let's say like this one is too loose and this one's tight, but you want it tight. So then you just make it tighter on here. So now we're going to get into cleaning your cube. Because before you put lube in it, you're gonna wanna clean it. Because like if your lube mixes with all the dirt in the cube, it might clean it, but also it might like get like make it work. It's kinda. So I've never cleaned this thing, and I've had it for like 2 months, and you can see in there. And yeah, it's just not good. So first, before you do that, you're gonna want to maybe just get on the outside, clean what you can from the outside real quick with like an ear wad if you have that, and just like clean those corners, and yeah, just like get all that out that you can. Here is what it is right here. You can see those little specks. That's from where the cube has all the dirt in it, but normally that will not work. So if when you adjust it, you probably also want to do the cleaning it at the same time. So at first it might be too tight. You're gonna have to loosen it real good to where it's like, so if you feel like it's like getting tighter, then go the other direction. But if you feel like, yeah, it's getting looser and I can, just keep going until like you feel like, oh, okay, I can pop a piece out now. And there we go. There's one piece popped out. Then you do that same thing with every piece. This is what it looks like inside of this cube. It's disgusting, really. And yeah, this is why you're going to want to clean this cube. So just first step is to just get out all those like pieces, doesn't matter how, just make sure they don't fly off like that one. But just make sure you have them all in one spot, like I do right here. And yeah, so just start getting all the pieces out. Once you have all the pieces out, this is what you're gonna wanna do. So first, what you're only gonna do is get it, your gloves on if you have them. I do, so I'm just gonna put my gloves on, and then I will show you how you're supposed to clean your cube. So you're first gonna want some baby wipes first, But also you're gonna want that little earpiece thing I got. So you can just scrape it all off thoroughly, not really thorough, just scrape it off to get that big stuff off. So like your baby wipe lasts longer. And I'm just gonna put this on time lap. La la la, whatever, la la la, it doesn't matter, la la la, oh well, la la la, we're going at it tonight. La la la, whatever, la la la, it doesn't matter, la la la, oh well, la la la. Next step, wiping. So after cleaning everything you got off, you don't need to get too much on it. The baby wipes will cover most of it. So then after that, you'll just get the baby wipes and just clean the cube. Also, just so you know, I'm sorry that I haven't been uploading as much recently. I was on vacation, so I wasn't really able to upload. And yeah, so I'm glad to be uploading again. I would like, in the comments, please ask me, tell me what would you want to see? Because you're the viewers and I can't do this without you guys. And yeah, I just want to know what you guys think of my videos and what you think I can improve on or anything I can do. Nothing too, like, I'm not asking for like a big, long report over what I can improve on and stuff like that. Also, when you clean these, you can also, if you want, you can just like put two in one baby wipe at once. So then you're like cleaning them both for as twice the speed. And like, but if you want to be like more thorough with it, like you should like get it and just be like cleaning it. And also like at the same time, be making sure like you're not just like saying you're like cleaning it and just like not really cleaning it and you're just like throwing baby wipes on it. And we are now on our last three pieces, and yes, and that is all you have to do for the cleaning part. Next is reassembling. So this is how you reassemble a cube. So you can take off the gloves at this point. And yeah, oh, also, I forgot, make sure to scrub the core too, because then it'll just get dirty right back how it was. So next step is to put it back together. Yeah, don't put it together randomly, because it might just be a scramble that cannot be solved, and then you're gonna have to take it over again. So just put it in the solved state, it's not that hard. All you do, put the right color in between its two, and I'll see you in a second. Hello guys, I'm trying to hit 30 subscribers by the end of this month. Right now we've got 22, and please subscribe, and I'll love it a lot. Thank you. Also guys, when you get to that very last edge or corner piece, I would prefer to either, like, actually, probably the best way would probably to be putting the edge in before you put the corner, because you're probably gonna want that edge in, and then once you get the edge in, like, the corner is pretty easy. You can just push it in like that. And now we're back onto tensioning. So remember how we loosened the cube to get it to like be able to take the piece out? Well, now you're gonna want to tighten that back up to your preference.
My personal preference would probably be a bit tighter than usual.
Probably might not be the best setting. Just make it to where like both of them are even, or like to where one is when you want it to be, and then make the other one where you want it to be. So I'm gonna get this one the same amount of flexibility. So you should check by pulling the top layer, pulling the bottom layer. So if I do this and I do this, it's about the same. So that means it is good. And now on to lube. So remember those gloves I told you? This is where they're most needed. So now that we have cleaned and adjusted the cube the way that we want to. Time to lube it. So lube, if you're new to cubing, lubricant is just something that you put in the cube to make it like turn better or slower, your preference, whatever you like. That doesn't mean like pour water or olive oil or WD-40. You should buy these type of lubes. Cubicle. I'm not sponsored by the Cubicle, but get them at the Cubicle. Just saying. The Cubicle is this. There. And yeah. So, now, my preference is to probably get maybe about to this, about, you probably want a little bit to put in the cube, so you want this, and then you just open a piece like this, like squeeze it open, and then when you do that, just put the lube that you want in there, just a few drops, maybe three, and then let's say you, oh no, that might be a little too fast or a little bit too slow, you might want to put at least one drop of the other like type of lube if you have another type. If you have like one that makes it slower, I might put about one or two drops more of the faster one, because that's what I'd like, and then put this. So you're also, if it's like a Pyraminx, like the lube normally just drips out. So don't do like soak it completely. Also, it's usually going to leave something behind like this right there, that little bit of mess. Also, make sure you don't do what I did and drop your lube, because it can be very messy. Also, keep this away from small children, as it says, I'm not a small little child, no matter what you say. Yeah, and just clean off the desk. Also, clean off the cube, because if you're lubing it, you most likely got at least some kind of lube on the outside. So you're probably gonna wanna just rub it over a bit to where it looks like the amazing cube that it is. And the lube fell. Yay. Okay, and yeah, so that is my video on how to tension your cube and lube it and just set it up how you like it. If there's anything else you added or you think you needed something else or don't need things like that, just tell me. And yeah, if you like this video, please subscribe and like and comment. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.